Dear students, through this video, I would like to explain how can we represent an irrational number in decimal form. Let us consider the example of square root of 2. While learning the definition of irrational numbers, we have seen that root 2, root 3, etc. are irrational numbers. So let us find out its decimal value. And for square root of a number, decimal value can be found out by performing long division. I hope you remember long division which you have done in class 8. So by performing this division step by step, I have got 1, 2, 3, 4 decimals. Still the numbers are continuing. In olden times, many mathematicians tried to find out the decimal value for root 2. Here a set of values, few decimal numbers are written here. Its value goes like this: 1.414123563230950488, etc. In all these digits, not even a single digit is repeating after a particular interval of time. So we can see that this expansion is non-terminating, non-repeating, or we can say non-terminating, non-recurring. So in rational numbers, in the previous video, we have learned that rational number can be expressed in decimal form, which is terminating or non-terminating, repeating. But irrational numbers are non-terminating, non-recurring. Another thing, we cannot bring this back to square root 2 form by the methods which we have used to bring the decimal form of a rational number to p by q form. So we can only convert irrational to decimal form, and an approximate value can only be found out since it is non-terminating, non-repeating. Questions based on this part can be of this form: find an irrational number between two given rational numbers. So 5 by 7, you put it into decimal form. 9 by 11 also put in decimal form. This starts with 7, this starts with 8. So an irrational number between them can be a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. So you can write it with your own choice of decimals, but it should be more than 0.7 and less than 0.8. Next, we are going to learn about representation of square root of a decimal number on number line. In previous classes, we have learned how to represent square root of a number like root 2, root 3, etc. on number line. And here we are going to learn about decimal number on a number line. Both the constructions are entirely different, so you should not get confused with the constructions. Once you learn construction of root 2, root 3, etc. thoroughly, then only try to learn decimal numbers on number line. Now, draw the perpendicular bisector of AC. So from C, you open your compass more than half and draw an arc above and below the line segment. And from A, you have to intersect it and join this intersecting point. While joining, it will meet the line at a point which is the midpoint of AC. Let us mark it as O. Now with center O and radius OA or OC, draw a semicircle. With center O and OA as radius, draw a semicircle. Now at P, draw a perpendicular which will meet this semicircle at a point D. So at B, I have drawn a semicircle. From this point, draw arcs. And from here, draw an arc, and from here, intersect it and join this intersecting point with B and extend it to touch the semicircle. So this point is joined and extended to touch the semicircle at D. Now, next step is to join OD. So we have joined OD. Now we have got a right triangle here. Now, geometrical meaning I will interpret. Before that, let me complete the construction. With B as center and D as radius. With B as center and D as radius, draw an arc. Draw an arc which meet the number line at this point, and let that point be P. Now let's think of the geometrical meaning and what does the value BD, BP or P, OD, OC, OA etc. represent. In construction part, we have taken AB is equal to 9.3 and BC equals 1 centimeter. So we can say AC is 10.3. Then, since O is the midpoint of AC by construction, OA equals OC. And D is a point on this semicircle. So OA, OD and OC, all the three are radii of this semicircle. Hence we can say OD equals OA equals OC and AC is 10.3. So what will be the value of OA, OD, OC? Half of 10.3. 10.3 divided by 2. We will not divide because it will again increase the number of decimals. Now, what is the value of OB? We actually don't know what is it, but we know what is the value of OC. OC is 10.3 divided by 2 and BC is 1. So, OC minus BC will give you OB. So, OB is equal to OC minus BC. That is 10.3 by 2 minus 1. By taking LCM, you will get 10.3 minus 2 whole divided by 2. That is 8.3 by 2. So we have got the value of OD, OA, OC and then OB. Now consider the right triangle that we have made here. OBD. Here we know what is the value of OD. OD is 10.3 divided by 2. And we know what is the value of OB. It is 8.3 divided by 2. But we don't know what is the value of BD. And we have made this semicircle with BD as radius. So we need to find the value of BD. And in this right triangle, if you apply Pythagoras theorem, OD square is equal to OB square plus BD square. And we need to find out BD square. So keep it on the left side. So BD is equal to square root of OD square minus OB square. That is 10.3 by 2 square minus 8.3 by 2 square. This can be done by 10.3 square by 4 minus 8.3 square by 4. Since denominators are same, numerators are of the form a square minus b square. So we can apply that formula here. Square root of denominator is 4. 10.3 plus 8.3 into 10.3 minus 8.3. So you will get 18.6 into 2 divided by 4, which is under square root. So on cancelling here, you will get square root of 18.6 divided by 2. On dividing these two, you will get square root of 9.3. So from the figure, we found that value of BD is 9.3. Now taking B as center and BD as radius, we have made this arc which touch the number line at P. So BD and BP are equal because they are parts of the same arc. So if BD is square root of 9.3, then BP is also square root of 9.3. So this part represents square root of 9.3. Hope you understood the construction. Try to practice similar questions from the exercise. Thank you.